Hi there. Stan the Medical Minuteman here, back with another Medical Minute Monday. This week I'm reviewing antipyretics. What are antipyretics, and how do they affect the body? An antipyretic is any substance that reduces fever. Some common antipyretics are acetaminophen and non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs, commonly referred to as NSAIDs. Popular over-the-counter NSAIDs include aspirin, ibuprofen, and naproxen. To better understand how antipyretics work, let's take a look at prostaglandins and their effect on the hypothalamus. Prostaglandins are derived from fatty acids in the cell membrane. These fatty acids are cut off membrane lipids by an enzyme known as phospholipase A2. An enzyme called cyclooxygenase forms an intermediate prostaglandin called prostaglandin H2. This intermediate is further modified to form a variety of prostaglandins, one of which is prostaglandin E2. Prostaglandin E2 acts on the hypothalamus. Much like a thermostat regulates the temperature inside your home, the hypothalamus regulates your body temperature. Stimulated by prostaglandin E2, the hypothalamus resets the thermostat to a higher temperature. Acetaminophen and NSAIDs are prostaglandin antagonists. They inhibit cyclooxygenase, therefore inhibiting synthesis of the intermediate prostaglandin H2. With the synthesis of the intermediate interrupted, there is less prostaglandin E2 available to stimulate the hypothalamus. This leads to a decrease in the body's temperature. In addition to the previously discussed drugs, corticosteroids have antipyretic effects, but they work differently by inhibiting the enzyme phospholipase A2. Now that you have a general understanding of what antipyretics are and how they work, let's review some practical need-to-know information that will benefit you on the floor. Most healthcare providers will initiate treatment with antipyretics if a patient's fever is 101 degrees Fahrenheit or more, or if the patient's comfort level could be improved. Dosing is weight-based, and which antipyretic is given will depend on the patient's age. Acetaminophen is dosed at 15 mg per kilogram every 4 to 6 hours and is considered safe for patients who are at least 2 months old. Ibuprofen is dosed at 10 mg per kilogram every 6 to 8 hours and is considered safe for patients who are at least 6 months old. Aspirin is not advised in young pediatric patients. This is because aspirin use following viral illnesses such as influenza or chickenpox has been linked to an increased risk for Reye syndrome. There have been studies stating that combination therapy, which is the rotation of ibuprofen and acetaminophen, provides more consistent antipyresis. When your healthcare provider provides antipyretics counseling to the patient or parent, be sure to document which antipyretic or antipyretics are being prescribed, the discussed dosage, and the frequency. The healthcare provider may have this information added to the discharge paperwork as well. I hope that you've enjoyed this week's Medical Minute. Antipyretics are truly amazing drugs that have a wide variety of applications. If you liked this video, please give a thumbs up. If you loved it, consider subscribing to our channel. Please join me next Monday for a review of rapid influenza diagnostic tests. And for more updates like these, come join us online.